गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, वेलकम टू VEPS ई लर्निंग क्लास. चिल्ड्रेन, एज यू नो दैट आर रिविजन इज गोइंग ऑन एंड वी हैव कम्प्लीटेड द रिविजन ऑफ चैप्टर 4, दैट वॉज मल्टीप्लीकेशन. नाउ वी हैव स्टार्टेड रिविजन ऑफ चैप्टर 5 ऑल्सो, दैट इज डिविजन. वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द टर्म्स ऑफ डिविजन, डिविजन इन दैट एंड द डिविजन फैक्ट्स and exercise 5A. So what we will do, we will at first revise the terms and the facts of division. So children, there are 4 terms in division, that is dividend, divisor, quotient and remainder. So children, what is dividend? Dividend is the number which is being divided in the division, so that is called dividend. Now what is divisor? The number which is going to divide the dividend, that is called the divisor. And what is quotient? The result of the division is called quotient. And what is remainder? The number which is left over after the division, that is called what? Remainder. Now we will revise facts of division. What is the first fact of division? It was every multiplication fact has 2 division fact. Means in one multiplication fact, we are having 2 division fact. What is second? The second was when the number is divided by itself, what will be the answer? Answer will be 1. And when the number is divided by 1, what will be the answer? Answer will be the number itself. And the fourth fact is when the any number is being divided by 0, it is 0 is meaningless in the division, but if any number is given that we have to divide it by 0, what will be the answer? The answer will be always 0. So children, these are the 4 facts which we have discussed and the 4 terms which we have discussed, and one thing is more given in the division, that is the checking fact. That the method for checking the fact is, what is? One formula I have given you in the book, it is given also on page number 91, that was quotient multiply by divisor plus remainder, and the answer will be dividend. When we multiply quotient by divisor and we will add what? Remainder in that, the answer will come the same as the dividend given in the quotient. So this means that the division which we have done, it is correct. So children, now we will start the revision of exercise 5B. So let us start. Now I will give you some questions, I will explain you, then after that I will give you some question to solve from the same exercise. Clear? That you will solve in your copy and send me the picture of it for correction. If you will have any doubts, children, you can ask me on the WhatsApp group. Clear? Now let's start our revision. Now children, exercise 5B, we will revise some question. It is divide and verify your answer. Now we will divide it first and we will verify the answer that it is correct or not. So children, 76 divided by 11. So we will divide 76 by 11 here. 11 6 are 66. 66 is nearest to the 76 because 11 7 will be 77. So 77 will be greater than 76. So it can't be minus or you can say subtract. So we will use 11 6 are 66 here. Now 6 minus 6 is 0, 7 minus 6 is 1. So here quotient is 6 and the remainder is 10. What is the divisor, children? Divisor is 11. Now let us verify the answer. Q multiply by D plus R is equal to dividend. Now Q is 6, means quotient is 6, D divisor is 11, and R remainder is 10. So 6 11s are 66. 66 plus 10, it is 76. So you can see 76 is the same as given in the question, question number 1, that is the dividend of the question, and here 76 is given. So it means that the division which we have done, it is correct. Now question number 2, 96 divided by 14. 14 6 are 84. So 14 6 are 84, we will minus here. 6 minus 4, 2, 9 minus 8, 1. What is the remainder? 12 is the remainder, and question is 6. Now let us verify the answer. Q multiply by D plus R. These are the short forms. Q is the short form of question. D is the short form of divisor. R is the short form of remainder. So is equal to dividend. 6 multiply by 14. What will come? 84. 6, 14, 6 are 84. Now we will add 12 in that. So 4 plus 2, 6. 8 plus 1, 9. So 96 is the answer, and 96 is same as the dividend given in the question number 2. Question number 3 now. 58 divided by 18. 18 threes are 54. 54 is nearest to the 58. So 8 minus 4 is 4, and 5 minus 5 is 0. So here 3 is the question and 4 is the remainder. Now let us verify the answer. Q multiply by D plus R is equal to dividend. 3 18s are, or 18 3s are 54 again. Now we will add 4 in 54. What will come? 58. 58 is the answer after checking, and 58 is the dividend also given in the question. So the both are same. It means that the division which we have done, it is correct. Question number 4. 70 divided by 15. 15 4s are 60. 60 is nearest to the 70. Now 0, 0 will be 0. 7 minus 6 will be 1. So the 10 is remainder here and 4 is quotient here. Now let us verify the answer. Q multiply by D plus R is equal to dividend. Q is 4, D is 15, R is 10. 4 15s are, or 15 4s are, is 60. 60 plus 10 is 70. So 70 is the answer also, and 70 is the dividend which is given in the question. So these both are same. It means that the division which we have done, it is correct. Now children, question number 5. 234 divided by 12. We'll divide 234 by 12 here. 12 ones are 12. 3 minus 2, 1. 2 minus 1, 1. Now we will copy down 4 from here. It will become the digit, the number is 114. Now 12 nines are 108. 4 minus 8, we can't do that. So 4 will borrow 1 from here. It will become 14, and this will remain 0. Means 0 will be remain here. So 14 minus 8 is 6. Here 19 is the question and 6 is the remainder. Now let us verify the answer here. Q multiply by D plus R is equal to dividend. 19 is the quotient and 12 is the divisor. So 19 12s are, or we will multiply 19 by 12. Here you can do in rough also as I have done. So it will come 228. Now we will add 6 in this. 228. What will be the answer? 234. So 234 is same as the dividend given in the question. So children, this means that the division is correct. Now question number 6, 175 divided by 23. 23, 7's are is 161. So we will multiply 7 by 23 and it will come 161. Now let us subtract it from 175. 5 minus 1, 4. 7 minus 6, 1. And 1 minus 1 will be 0. Now let us verify the answer. Q is 7. D, divisor is 23. And the remainder is 14. Now what we will do? We will multiply 7 by 23 or 23 by 7. Answer will come same. So what will be the answer? 161. Now we will add 14 in 161. What will come? 175. And it is same as the dividend which is given in the question. This means that, this shows that the division which we have done, it is correct. Okay children. Now I will give you some question. You will solve it and send it for correction. And children, your homework is revise exercise 5C 5C for next revision. Thank you and have a nice day.